What was the most memorable school event you experienced during high school?
Totem.
Okay. River?
Probably having a lot of Pepsis at Totem.
Okay. Cam?
I'm just going to agree with the Pepsis at Totem.
Probably the pep rallies.
Okay. And Danae?
I'd say
Totem. What are you doing in 10 years?
Living on a beach somewhere.
Oh, okay.
Most
In 10 years, I see myself traveling the world.
Okay, that's cool. All right, and second question. What's a piece of advice you'd give to the kids moving up to the high school?
Walk on the proper side of the hallway, please.
Okay.
Keep to yourself. Everyone likes to talk.
Your spots are important that bring you the most memories.
Probably McLeod School Park.
Okay.
Noodle Box.
Okay. If there's one thing you could tell your grade 8 self, what would it be?
Shut up. No one cares.
Yeah, don't be so loud. People think you're annoying.
Yeah, tell your grade 8 self, what would it be?
Don't
me?
Yeah.
Weed isn't as bad as it sounds.
Okay. And then most memorable night.
And the answer to the news.
He tried to steal our friend's car once. Yeah.
See yourself doing in 10 years.
Who are we starting with?
Yeah.
I'm teaching somewhere.
Good. Anna?
I don't actually know, but somewhere cool.
Awesome. Palace?
I hope somewhere cool. I hope not here.
Yeah.
That'd be nice.
Fair enough. Peter?
One thing you could tell your grade 8 self, what would it be?
Stop being stupid in the beginning. Nobody cares. Literally just do your work. Pay attention to math. That's all.
Good job.
I probably taught myself to not compare myself to people older than me. Because, yeah, you're gonna, like, you grow up to become them. So.
Yeah. If you had the option, would you want to stay a high schooler for longer, or are you ready to move on to the next chapter of your life?
I would not want to stay in high school any longer, just because I feel like it's kind of part of your life to leave and then get going on your future, so
yeah,
I'm ready to go.
Yeah. Okay, I have one more question. This is just quick. What was your first real job in high school? And did you like it?
I was a pharmacy assistant at Shoppers Drug Mart. I was there for 3 years. It's pretty good.
Nice.
Good job. I still have my first job. I work at the bakery.
Good. All right. Where are the landmarks or spots are important that bring you the most memories?
I would say Canal Beach and Victoria Key.
All right. And if there's one thing you could tell your grade 8 self, what would it be?
Not to get into the drama.
Fair enough.
Yeah, most of it doesn't matter.
And what was your guys' most memorable night?
You on first.
Hannah.
Partying at the warehouse.
Okay.
March 2nd, 2021.
April 22nd, 2021.
Okay. If you could tell your grade 8 self one thing, what would it be?
To try a little harder.
Okay.
Don't be stupid.
High school's really not as scary as it seems.
Okay, and then did high school meet the expectations you thought it was going to be?
Absolutely not.
Okay.
No, not.
If you guys had the option, would you want to stay a high schooler for longer, or are you ready to move on to the next chapter of your life?
I'm ready to move on.
Ready to move on.
Okay. And then the next question is, how did your perspective on high school change over the years, like your priorities and worries?
Well, first coming up to high school, I was more worried with, like, how am I going to fit in, who are my friends going to be, that sort of thing. But as I got older, I realized that doesn't matter as much as keeping grades up, kind of knowing where you want to go with your life, and just having your priorities sorted out.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, it comes down to making sure you yourself are healthy, mentally, physically, and you know what you want to do. And it's okay to be stressed, because God knows you're going to be stressed.
Yes.
Yeah. I just say, like, setting aside more time for myself and
that's a good one.
Working on my mental health, whatnot.
Yes. That's a report that bring you guys the most memories.
Oh, damn. Landmarks? So we got,
like spots that you guys hang out with your friends.
Victoria Key.
Okay.
And Marina. That's about it. We ain't got shit down here.
True. And Phoenix?
Yeah, probably.
Same things?
Probably Victoria.
Okay. And what do you see yourself doing in 10 years? Okay. High school changed throughout the years, like your priorities or worries, etc. And you can start.
When I first came to high school, I was more like worried about like social acceptance and like fitting in and popularity and stuff like that. And now I feel that I'm definitely more focused on like leaving, graduating, and doing well. And,
Yes. Okay. Naya, what about you?
I think mine was probably the opposite. When I came to school, I was very focused on grades, and I don't know. I don't really worry about school much anymore, and I think that's what's changed. I've learned to just kind of
live in the moment.
Yeah, and just have fun at school because I found that, you know, if you don't worry as much, my grades at least improved.
Yeah. Wow. There you go. What about you, Noah?
Starting in grade eight, I was definitely more focused on like what people thought of me and how that would change going to the high school, especially meeting a lot of new people. But as I've gone up in the grades, I've kind of realized that that doesn't matter so much, and so I focus more on myself and improving myself and also working on my studies.
Yeah, okay, good job. Okay, and next question. Out of your entire high school experience, who are your favorite and least favorite teachers? So, if you have one.
My favorite teachers are probably like Kainok and Gauche.
Okay. Ben, yep.
Least favorite teacher is Mr. Bodner.
Oh!
Absolutely.
I figured that one was gonna come from him. Okay. What about you, Naya?
My favorite teacher is Miss Pearson. Always first.
Okay.
Also, Mr. Clark in grade 9, because he really like pushed me. I know.
Oh, okay. Damn. That's the first time I've heard that.
And then least favorite, I'll have to go with Dakota as well for the feminist angle.
Yeah,
that's
okay.
Not okay.
Okay, fair enough.
My least favorite teacher is definitely Mr.
He's a sub to it.
He's a sub. And my favorite teacher is definitely Miss McClure.
All right. Out of your entire high school experience, who are your favorite and least favorite teachers?
My least favorite teacher was Miss.
Okay.
My favorite teacher was Miss Bohar.
Yes. Okay. Good. You?
Okay. For me, favorite would have to be Mr. Merwin.
Who?
Mr. Merwin.
Oh, who is that? Mr. Merwin.
Yeah. And then my my least favorite would be she really doesn't like me.
My favorite teacher would be Mr. Pierwall, and my least favorite would be
Mr. Lane, he is the best! Okay, next question. What was your first real job in high school?
I was a program assistant at the rink.
Okay. Cool.
I was a lawn mower for my brother.
Oh, cool! Adam never had a job in high school.
No, I didn't.
Okay, next question. Okay, well, we can cut that part out. And then I'll ask a random one. Just give me a second. I have to find one. Okay, what's a piece of advice you'd give to the kids moving into the high school?
Learn how to walk in the hallways.
Okay.
Go to school.
And Adam? Come on.
Okay, what's a piece of advice you'd give to the kids moving up to the high school next year?
Go to class.
Okay, perfect. What about you, Kaden?
Don't be in the bathroom during class.
Okay. And did high school meet the expectations you thought it was going to be?
Yeah.
All right. Sweet. What do you guys see yourselves doing in 10 years?
Nothing.
Okay. Work in my mom's company.
Okay.
Mom's basement.
All right. What were you guys' least favorite and favorite teachers in high school?
We'll skip this one.
I don't like Miss. And I love Miss Hurst.
Yes.
That's so true. When's this video gonna come out? By next semester? Oh, Miss. And I don't know. I like Lil Raji.
Okay. What about you, Pepper?
Oh yeah, I said August.
No,
yeah.
Cheatham. I like Cheatham.
Okay.
Cheatham.
And last question: what was your guys' ultimate favorite high school memory?
Probably watching Parker out on Snow Creek. Classic BC.
Yep.
Don't remember much of Snow Creek. Probably. Probably at Trill Pit that one night.
Oh, which one?
Can you handle this wood?
Oh. Yeah, probably that one.
Okay, Nat, what about you?
Last year's basketball season.
Okay.
What do you guys see yourself doing in 10 years?
In 10 years, I see myself back at the high school teaching art and things.
Oh, cool. That's awesome. And you, Amanda?
Probably, like, that's hard to say. I want to say maybe like working in a cafe or like a bakery.
Oh, cute.
And like just giving back to the people in need.
That's cute. Okay. And last but not least, how did your perspective on high school change throughout the years? So like your priorities or worries or whatever.
So I was homeschooled from grade kindergarten to grade 10, and then I was here for grade 11 and 12.
Okay.
So like my priorities?
Yeah, priorities.
The priorities, it basically stayed the same though, just getting good grades. Yeah. But then when I came to high school, I wanted to make a lot of friends.
Yeah,
and build a nice community. So it's been great.
Cool, okay.
For me, I wasn't here in grade 8, I was up north.
Yeah.
So from grade 9 till like grade 10, I was just trying to
branch
go
out.
Through.
Yeah.
And I didn't really care much, and then in grade 11 to 12, it was like, oh, I should get stuff done and like worry more about my grades. Great.
If you had the option, would you want to stay a high schooler for longer, or are you ready to move on?
I'm ready to move on.
Okay.
Ready to move on. As much as I don't want to be here, high school went by too fast.
All right, what's the piece of advice you'd give to the kids moving up to high school?
Because moving up?
Yeah, like that you would want to know when you were in grade.
High school's really not that scary.
Okay.
People are like, it's a big high school. It's not.
Yeah.
It's really not that bad.
Good choice. And then the next one is, what was the most memorable school event you experienced during high school?
School event?
Yeah.
Like, totally.
Okay, what do you guys see yourself doing in 10 years from now?
20 minutes in.
Say the same thing if you want.
Yeah, turning my turn.
Okay. And the second question is, what advice would you guys give to the grade 8s going up to the high school next year?
Walk on the right side of the hallway.
Good. Good idea. Come on, Connor.
Don't be.
You don't have to worry, cause baby, there ain't no mountain high enough, ain't no valley low enough, ain't no river wide enough to keep me from getting to you, baby. Remember the day I set you free, I told you you could always count on me, darling. From that day on, I made a vow, I'll be there when you
she want me.
Stop being so mean!
I'll be
to bed. You interrogate that bitch like you the fed. So she says she in love with a rock star, rock star. Wanna smoke my weed, so she asked me where the tops are, tops are.
Oh,
top draw.
Ain't no mountain high enough. Ain't no valley low.